What's up, guys? It's Likwid, West Texas Vaping Coalition, back at you again today with my review of, ta-da, the Cool Fire 2 by Innokin. Got this over at the Vape Shack, picked it up today, so I figured I already have the Cool Fire 1. Better get the Cool Fire 2, see what the difference are, and see which one I like better, and add it to the collection, of course. The difference from the Cool Fire 2 and the Cool Fire 1, the Cool Fire 2 is going to be variable voltage. So we're going to check this thing out. I already checked my authentication code out to make sure it's an authentic iTaste product. And of course, like I should even ask from the good people over at the Vape Shack, of course it is an official iTaste product or an Innokin product. The Cool Fire 2 is going to come in two colors. It's going to come in black and jungle camo. So I went with the jungle camo because, hey, I don't have anything jungle camo. So let's see what it says on the back here. Cool Fire 2 has a battery level indicator, a reverse battery protection circuit, built-in 7-amp fuse for protection and stability, short circuit protection, on-off switch. Wow, okay, cool. LED battery power display, low voltage warning, overtime vaping warning for 10 seconds. So if you vape longer than 10 seconds, it's going to shut off. Battery safety protection, which is going to be the vent holes, and high compatibility 510 connection. So here's the box. I don't have a different camera still because it's Christmas and I don't have time to spend money on other things like myself. But we're going to do the unboxing. You ready? There, I unboxed it. In the box you're going to find your quick guide to show you how to get it set up quickly. A user manual. Very small user manual. I did go through this really quick, and just so you guys know, where was it at? It shows that this one is variable wattage only, and it's going to run your maximum output voltage is going to be 6 volts unloaded. It's just so you guys know that. I'm sure you're happy about that. Okay, here's the unit. This is, whoa, there's a Cool Fire 2. Here's the thing you don't understand. The Cool Fire 2 in black, you'll get a black device and a smoke tank. For some strange reason, with the Cool Fire 2 jungle camo, you get the green device and for some strange reason, a purple tank. Anyway, the cool thing about the iClear 30B that comes with this one is that it has that swivel nozzle head on it as opposed to the straight head on the Cool Fire 1, the 30B that comes with the Cool Fire 1. So first thing I'm going to do with it, I'm going to mod it. Ready? We're going to take this purple tank off and we're going to put on the green tank. Kind of makes more sense to me. Having a green tank with a green. That's just me. So, let's go through this really quick top to bottom. On the top, you are going to have this beauty cap. That's going to come off. And that'll expose your 510 and your Eagle Thread connection. The cool thing about this is, I don't know if you can tell or not, it's got breather holes in the cap. So at least you're going to have air draw. I did notice when I take this cap off, the wattage wheel here, if you will, gets kind of loose, so I don't know if you want to be careful with that. It looks like there's a lock nut on top of that as well to hold that into place. So that's that. I guess you could take this off for cleaning or whatever reason else you want to take it off. Put this back on. I did notice the threading on this top cap, and it's not just a plastic cap. There's actual metal insert, and it's very, very grindy. It's almost like it needs to be cleaned up a little bit. Having a little trouble putting it back on now. Yep. That's lovely. See, this is what I get for trying to do things in one take. But we'll get it back together. Okay, there it goes. So we'll put that back on. And then, moving down the device, you will have your wattage wheel. Now get this. Another weird thing. Innokin, I don't know what they're thinking half the time. Starts off at 7 watts. Then goes to 8 watts. From 8 it goes 8.5, 9, 9.5, 10.5, 11, 12, and 12.5. Not really sure what happened to 10. Maybe Innokin don't think we need 10 watts, so they skipped over it. But whatever, at any rate. And it's got the little button here, and same thing as every other Innokin product, three pushes, one, two, three. You get the little light show. I know it's kind of hard to see because of the window, but that's going to be the same thing. Your green is going to mean you have a full battery, yellow, partial battery, red. Time to change it. Nice little Coolfire logo right there. It's all built in, nice and billet. Moving down, it's got a nice, decent base, so it sits solid, and it's not plastic, people. It's made out of some kind of metal. I probably could have looked it up, but I'm sure somebody out there will do a better review than me. But then you got your bottom cap. The bottom cap, it is vented. There is some tiny little air holes in there. And for some reason, I only think that there's two, because it looks like the rest are clogged. Well, maybe three. Maybe I'm completely wrong. But it just seems like the air holes, the vent holes could have been a little bit bigger. It would have made me feel better. This is going to be the same thing as Coolfire 1. We're going to take the 18350 battery. I am using a flat top battery, and it seems to be working okay. But to me, down at the bottom, it seems like... Hold on, I'm sticking my finger in it. Yeah, you'll be okay with the flat top battery. So, and it's got a very nice, sturdy, stiff spring, same as the SVD. So I like that. So we're going to put this bad boy together. The bottom threads seem to be a lot better. And we'll give it a vape and we'll talk a little bit about it. Put my green iClear on here. And if I'm not mistaken, and I might be because I've been mistaken before, let's just see for argument's sake if I can take the tip off this. Look at there. Well, now I have my angle tip on my green tank and my green B. So let's take a vape, see what we think. Does not work at all because I didn't turn it on. Now let's try to give it a vape. These iClear 30Bs are this close away from making my mind up and switching my 22 Pro Tank 2s for these. And I'll show you when I refill this, and you've probably seen it in the other video that I did for the Coolfire 1, what's almost keeping me from switching. Let's take another vape. Twelve and a half watts, man, and it's not burning, it's not fighting for liquid. These the tanks that come with these, the iClear 30Bs, are built very, very well. I still don't understand why they're written upside down, like everything's written upside down, but that's their thing. But they taste wonderful. I mean, it's a good flavor. I was kind of worried because it is a plastic tank that I was going to get that, especially with a dual coil. I figured when that starts getting warm, it's going to warm that plastic up, and I'm going to get a plasticky type taste. I did get that at first, but that went right away after my third or fourth vape, and I think that was just breaking in the atomizer. And I've been vaping on this for about 2 hours, and it's wonderful. Really good vapor production. Flavor's really good. I like the way that they built the dual coils on this as opposed to the Pro Tank, where they're just, you know, two coils sitting directly on top of each other and it's kind of like deal with it. With the 30B, they crisscrossed them. So they sit like this. So you have wicks on all four sides. So you get massive, massive flavor delivery, massive juice delivery, good vapor production. The only thing... And I really can't say it's a drawback because it is an 18350. I've been vaping on this for a couple hours. This was a full tank when I started, and the tank's about empty, and so is the battery. I'm on red right now, so the battery lasted me about 2 hours. But I guess, you know, for an 18350, that's not that bad. I've did some chain vaping to see if I was going to have some fall off. It doesn't fall off or anything like that. It's really well. It's well made. Cool little conversation piece. Can't wait to go through TSA and vape on this and see what happens. I think we're going to be okay. Looks a little bit different than the pre-production. The pre-production, I mean, it looked exactly like a freaking grenade. I don't know if you guys seen pictures or not. So they kind of revamped it a little bit. And I think it's because they didn't want it to look so realistic that you'll get in trouble. Let's try that on a nice high angle. I do like the swivel-y thing. It's pretty cool. Another thing I think it kind of falls on, and that's on the drip tip. If you look at the tip, see how it's wide open, but then there's a little dinky hole there? On the backs of them, you know, they're all wide open. And I know that a lot of people like a tighter draw. I like them, you know, I want to be able to get a lot of vapor. So what I did on the original tip that came on the green one, on the Coolfire one, is I drilled the whole thing out, and I think I get better vapor production here. You tell me. Here's the one with the restricted tip. Decent. And here's the one with the bored out tip. I get more flavor, I believe, from this one. I think this one, you got a bunch of flavor that's coming up through the, you know, the bottom of this. I mean, look, it's opened up nice and wide, but look at that hole at the end. It's just, I think it's suffocating it. And I think that causes condensation stuff build up in there, plus you have probably some juice build up in there, and then it'll fall back down into the tank. But I really think that I wish they would sell like an open model. But maybe this is a tip for you guys, and you'll like it. But all in all, I think it's pretty neat. Coolfire 2 by Innokin. It is what it is. I mean, it gives you one step up from the Coolfire 1, which is just an on button. There's no variable voltage, no variable wattage. You're going to get 12.5 watts on this, and it seems to handle well. And we're going to take one more vape here, and then I will go ahead and maybe I'll do another review. Let's see. Hey, make sure you tell your friends, too, to like my channel, or if you guys got any comments, please put them below. As soon as I get to the 1,000th subscriber, I got a cool giveaway. I think I'm going to give away a VTR just to make, I guess, con you people into watching my videos or something. But I dig it. If there's anything you guys want me to check out, or if there's anything you want me to talk about, anything you want me to review, just leave them in the comments below, and I will get them. So here's you guys. If I don't get another one done, it's because we're busy with the holidays and stuff, and Merry Christmas, Happy Holiday, Kwanzaa, whatever it is you do. For me personally, Merry Christmas. And got vape. Oh yeah, baby. Maybe I'll leave one of these for Santa Claus. He gets so many milk and cookies, you know, house after house after house. You imagine getting a nice Santa Claus plate, and maybe say, "Dear Santa, I know you're having a hard time, and you know, got to hit all these houses up, so here, I didn't get you cookies or anything like that, but here's really cool Coolfire 2 and maybe a shot of whiskey." I think Santa drinks. It's a lot of milk and cookies. You can't just live on milk and cookies alone. I think he'd like to have a Coolfire 2 and a shot of bourbon or something. You know, maybe, you know, nice fine wine. I don't see him in wine. I think he'd be like a shot guy. Santa's a shot guy. So there you go. Merry Christmas, guys, and I'll see if I can get another video up before the holidays hit. If not, you know, I'll see you guys on some of the other forums. And I guess that's pretty much it. I don't know what else to say. Da 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 da. Boop.